In this video, I teach you a construction of milling machine, means the various component of the milling machines in the details by using this animation, so you can understand it easily and also in the easy language. So first we understand the most important part of the milling machine is the base. So what is the base? It is the foundation member for all other parts which rest upon it, means it is the main foundation, and above the base all the other components are mounted, and it carry the column at its one end, means on the one sides of the base we mount the column. So here the next component is coming to the column, and it act as a load taking member for all other parts, means it take the load of all other parts of the machines and receive reservoirs for the coolant. So in the base we are also able to store the coolant because it is the hollow part, so in that base we are also able to store the coolant or a oil. Then after, next component is the column. So column is installs on the one sides of the base. So what is the important points of the column? The column is the main supporting member mounted vertically on the base. So it is the one vertical part, it is mount on the base. Next is, it is a box shape, means its shape is like the box, and heavily ribbed inside and house all the driving mechanisms for the spindle and table feed. Means it is hollow component. Inside this column, on the top part there are spindle is installed and the driving mechanisms for the spindle, and the bottom part, that is a table feed mechanism, is also installed. The front vertical face of the column is accurately machined, means these sides of the machine is accurately, these sides of the column is accurately machined and is provided with the dovetail guide wheel for supporting the knee. So what is a dovetail guide wheel? This type of the vertical guide wheels is provided on this surface, and on this vertical dovetail shape the knee is mounted, means this type of the portion is installed on this column and this side is connected with this knee. So knee is moving up and down on the surface of the column. On the top of the column, overarm is supported, means on the one side we mount the knee and table of the column, and upper parts of the column, means the top of the column, we installs the overarm is supported. So next we study the overarms. Before moving on to overarm, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels and also comment on the video. And if you want to watch more video related to manufacturing process and another subject of the mechanical engineering, then go to the playlist and watch that video. So next component is overarm. So it is mount on the top part of the column. So what is the function of this overarm? So it is mounted on the top of the column, which is extended behind the column, means it is extended behind the column, means it is a larger than this column width behind the column face, and serve as a bearing supports for the another end of the armor, means it is generally used to support the another end of the armor. One end of the armor is connected with this spindle and spindle is mounted inside this column that we seen later on. To support the projecting arbor, it can slide horizontally, forward, backward, and adjusted at required position. This overarm is also moving, okay, that is moving forwards and backwards horizontally in these directions according to these required positions. Next component is the brass. In a some book it is written as the front brass. It is a extra support which is fitted between the knee and overarm to ensure the further rigidity to the another end of the arbor. So these brasses connect this overarm, and here the knee is mount, so it's connect the overarms and the knee, so it's give the more rigidity to the our systems, and it is also support the end of the arbor. Next part is the yoke. This yoke is support the another end of the arbor. In some of the machines only one part is provided, either a brace or a yoke. So yoke is one type of the extra supports, okay, and this is the spindle. It is a spindle boss, that is known as the spindle. It is situated in the upper part of the column and receives the power from the motor throw bales, gear, clutches and transmit it to the arbor. So spindle is mount on a top part of the column and spindle is connected with this electric motor, so it is a one rotating components. And from motor to spindles, power is transferred by using the belt, gear, either the clutch, and this power is transmitted to the arbor. So here the arbor is connected. This red color part is the arbors. So arbor is various types. So here we only study the basic functions of the arbors. And if you want to watch the how many types of the arbor is there, then you go to the playlist and that watch the video. It is like an extensions of the machine spindle, means it is a one extension of the spindle on which milling cutters are securely mounted and rotated. So on this arbor, our cutter is mounted or a milling cutters are mounted. And here you see that another end of the arbor is supported by the yoke. And this yoke is moving on a different way according to this length of the arbor. So it is either moving on this side or this side. The arbor are made with a taper shank for a proper alignment with the machine spindles having a taper holes at their nose. So inside this spindle there is a taper shape is there. So shank of this arbor is taper. The draw bolt is used for managing for locking the arbors with the spindles. So here draw bolt is provided to fitting of these arbors. And the arbor assembly is consist of the following components. That is arbor, spindle, spacing collars, bearing, boost, cutter, draw bolts, lock nut, key block and set screw. Now we move towards the most important component. So here is the milling cutters that cut the our workpiece. Then after most important component is the knee. So here you see that is a knee. So knee is mount on this one face of the column and it is mount on the dovetail shape. And this knee is move in which direction? It is moving in up and down directions. Okay. By using this elevating screw or a screw jack. In some book, this is known as the screw jack or elevating screw. It is either move by a motors or by using the hand. So here we study the basic theory of knee. Knee is a rigid gray iron casting which slide up and down on a vertical way of the column face. So here dovetail guideways are provided. On a surface of dovetail guideways, the knee is moving up and down with the help of the screw jack. So by operating the screw jack or elevating screw with the help of hand wheel or a power feed. So it is knee is moving either by using the hand or a power and table height can be adjusted. So by moving up and down, we are able to adjust the distance between the workpiece as well as the table. So this motion is provided to adjustment of the space between the workpiece and the arbor, because every workpiece have a different height, so we need to adjust it with the moment of the knee. Table height or a distance between the cutter and the workpiece can be adjusted. So this is the basic of this knee. On the upper part of the knee, there is another guideways are provided for mounting the saddle, and the saddles are moving from side of the column or from away from the column, means that is in x directions. Okay, knee is moving up and down direction, saddle is moving in this direction. So at the last of the video I showed this perfect moment how that move by using this 3D image. So this is the saddle. Saddle is the intermediate part between the table and knee which act as a support for the table. So it is an intermediate part between the knee and table. So on the top part of the saddle we mount the tables. So saddle is a intermediate parts and knee which act as a support for the table. So saddle is provide support to the table. To provide cross feed to the table, the saddle can be adjusted crosswise along the guideways provided on the top of the knee. So this saddle is moving in this direction, means it is going near to column or away from the column. Okay. The horizontal guideways are provided at the top of the saddle along which table can be moved in a longitudinal directions. So on the saddle, on this direction, that is another direction that is not imagined in this figure. Suppose this consider there is Z direction and this is X direction. So on this Y direction, the guideways are provided on the saddles in which the table is moved. So next part is the table. So table is installed on a top part of the saddle And these tables are moving by using this hand wheel. So table is moving in longitudinal direction. The table is rest on the saddle and travel longitudinally. So table is installed on the saddle and it is moving in longitudinal directions. That we understand by using this actual image of the milling machines. A lead screw under the table engage a nut on the saddle to move the table horizontally by hand or a power. So in between this table and saddle, one lead screw is provided and which engage the nut on the saddles and to move table horizontally by hand or a power. So this hand wheel is provided. So by rotating this hand, we move the table in longitudinal directions. Either it is moved by using this power. In universal machines, the table may also be swivels horizontally, means it's move at the certain angles in a universal machine. For this purpose, table is mounted on a circular base. So this is mount on a circular base, means in between the saddles and table there is a one circular base is provided. On that table is mount. On for which purpose? For swiveling purpose. Okay, in some machine it is not swivel, then the circular base is not provided. The top of the table is accurately finished and the T slot are provided for clamping the work and other fixtures on it. So on the table, when you see from this side, you observe there is a various T type hole is there. So it is known as the T slots. So on this T slot, we are putting this different nut and bolt for clamping the work and different fixtures on the table. So on this table, we mount this workpiece, and for holding up the workpiece, one side of this side, we are providing indexing mechanisms and another side, tailstock is provided. And this workpiece is holding by using this clamp and varier mechanism like V-block and that. So if you want to watch the various types of the work holding devices, then go to the playlist and also go into the descriptions. So this is the actual image of the milling machines. So this is the knee part. So it is moving up and down direction, means this vertical direction, and it adjusts the space between this workpiece as well as the tool. Okay. And saddle is moving in this direction. This is go near to the column or away from the column. And this table, here you see that is a various T slot is provided. And this table is moving in this direction. This is known as the longitudinal direction. So these are the important thing in which direction which component is moving. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friend.